Now let's discuss constrained motion. When we talk about the constrained motion, we can simply state it as motion of a body restricted under some physical conditions or governed by some mathematical rules. Is called constrained motion. As you know, if we talk in layman's term, the constrained word means some restrictions. We talk about the horizontal plane on which a body is placed. If it is pulled by a horizontal force F, we can simply state that the body will move in a straight line. Due to this ground, we can say the body is constrained to move along a straight line. Say if here this ground ends, or say earlier the body was moving on a table and its corner is there. So as soon as the body will reach the corner of table, you can simply say its constraint for moving in a horizontal straight line will no longer exist and will start following a projectile sort of motion. In this situation, the body was constrained to move along a horizontal straight line till it was supported by the table. Then onward, it is falling freely under gravity. Maybe the force continues to act on it. So there is a motion which is constrained under the action of gravity and the external force. Similarly, say if there is an inclined plane having an angle of inclination alpha and a body is placed on it. We know well that the body will experience mg in downward direction. If this is a normal to plane along the incline, if this angle is alpha, it will be mg sin alpha. And due to mg sin alpha, the body will start sliding along the inclined plane. So here we can say, because of this inclined plane, the body is constrained to move along the angle of inclination alpha only, or it is constrained to move along the inclined surface only. So such type of motions we call constrained motion. Similar to that, if we talk about another situation in which say there is a pulley connected to the ceiling. On the two sides of pulley, there are two blocks hanging. Say these blocks are A and B, and we are given that mass of block B is more than mass of block A. So we can say obviously block B is heavier, it will go down and block A will move up. And we can say as these are connected by a string, they are constrained to move in such a way that their displacements will be equal and opposite. Say B will move down by a distance x, A must move up by the same distance x in the same time. Hence their velocity will be equal, as well as we can say their accelerations will be equal. So here we can say blocks A and B are constrained to move with the same speed and same acceleration magnitude. We can simply say whatever is the relation among their displacement, the same relation will exist between their speeds as well as magnitude of accelerations. Similarly, say if we talk in another concern on a horizontal plane, you can say there is a triangular block A over which there is another block B. As we can say, B is constrained to move along the inclined surface of this triangular wedge block. In this situation, if A moves toward left, say with an acceleration A1, and B moves on the surface of A with an acceleration A2, then in this situation we can state B is moving on the surface of block A with an acceleration A2, and along with this acceleration A2, it is also moving with acceleration A1 toward left. So here we can say block B is constrained to move on surface of A But in this situation for block B, if we carefully analyze its net acceleration, if this A2 is making an angle theta with the horizontal, its horizontal acceleration can be written as A2 cos theta, and in vertical direction its component will be A2 sin theta. And in this situation we can say, in x direction acceleration of block B can be written as A2 cos theta minus A1, because it is moving toward right in x direction with A2 cos theta, and along with block B it is also moving toward left with acceleration A1. So net acceleration of block B in horizontal direction will be A2 cos theta minus A1. Similarly, in y direction, if we talk, it is having only one acceleration, that is A2 sin theta. So if we find out the net acceleration of block B, this can be easily calculated by taking the magnitude by root of ax square plus ay square, will get the net acceleration. So be careful about such type of cases when a block moves over the other block. If its acceleration relative to the surface is given, as seen from ground, it will also have the acceleration of another block on which it is moving. Now let's talk about constraint relations. These are mathematical relations by which motion of two or more bodies are related. These are called constraint relations. We just take up a simple example to understand it. Say on a horizontal ground, there are two blocks, A and B. They are connected by a string. And say the block B is pulled with the horizontal force F. In this situation, as they are connected by an ideal inextensible string, and say block A is moving with the velocity V and B is moving with the velocity VB. Here we can simply state, if B moves by a distance X, A moves by a distance Y. Here we can directly state Y is equals to X, because they are connected by an inextensible string. So we just differentiate the relations with respect to time. So we can simply state Y is the displacement of A, then time derivative of this Y is VA. So VA can be written as time derivative of X, that will be VB. Or simply once again, if we differentiate it, it will give us acceleration of A, that is equals to acceleration of B. These all relation we call constraint relations. The first one is constraint relation of displacement, this constraint relation of velocity of the blocks. The third is constraint relation for acceleration of the blocks. So basically you need to keep one thing in mind. If you want to develop constraint relation for velocity and acceleration for any given bodies, so first you need to relate their displacements and then differentiate it with respect to time. You just keep it in your mind as a note also to develop constraint relations of velocity and acceleration. Try to relate displacement of bodies and differentiate with respect to time. This will give you the constraint relation of velocities and acceleration. Now we'll see some examples based on this logic.